Well, the NBA is responding to a letter from Georgia Senator Kelly Loeffler, co-owner of the Atlanta WNBA franchise, after she spoke out in opposition to the league's plan to promote the Black Lives Matter message when the season begins in late July. In a letter to the league, Commissioner Loeffler wrote, "In a time when polarizing politics is divisive as ever, sports has the power to be a unifying antidote. And now, more than ever, we should be united in our goal to remove politics from sports." In a statement, the league said they will continue to use our platform, they say, to vigorously advocate for social justice. Senator Kelly Loeffler has not served as governor of the Atlanta Dream since October 2019 and is no longer involved in the day-to-day business of the team. Well, my next guest had a more straightforward response to Loeffler. "We don't want her," is what she said. Joining me now is Natasha Cloud from the WNBA's Washington Mystics. I don't think you can put it plainer than that. Thank you for joining us, Natasha. So, why'd you say that? Well, tell me.
We don't. We have such a powerful league built up of so many strong, independent, powerful females. And we find pride in ourselves and being inclusive, our league being a safe space for everyone, regardless of your religion, your background, your walk of life, your sexual preference, any of those. We're a safe place for a lot of people. And in this very moment, we are using that platform and that leverage and the momentum that's behind this movement to continue to use our platforms and voices to be a voice for the voiceless. And that also means supporting Black Lives Matter. When our league is made up of 80% of Black females, this directly affects us. Every single day when we take off those uniforms, we walk out into the world and we can potentially be George Floyd. Shoot, we can be in our beds and be Breonna Taylor. So for her to come out and say that we're divisive and that Black Lives Matter movement is a divisive organization, I call her BS on that.
Why do you think some people just don't get it? What aren't they getting? What doesn't she get? What doesn't Loeffler get?
I don't know. I would love to have a conversation with her as well. You know, not only is our league 80% Black, but Atlanta in itself, their starting five is all Black females. So to be a partial owner in that and, you know, cheer on the sidelines and support your players, but you don't support them when they take those uniforms off, it's a problem. And that's not only a Loeffler problem, that's America's problem is, they look at us as athletes and expect us just to shoot and score and score touchdowns and not have an opinion about something that directly affects us.
Mm-hmm. So you have announced that you are not going to be playing this season because you want to focus on social reform. That has to be tough. Tell me about that decision.
It was super conflicting. We're a league made up of 144. I'm a mid-major kid. It was really hard to get into the league, even harder to stay in the league. We're coming off a championship season. So everything was kind of leading to, oh, this is going to be a great season again. And boom, Breonna Taylor, George Floyd, countless others, even after George Floyd. Lynchings going on in our country in 2020. Basketball is the last thing on my mind. Again, this directly affects me. It directly affects my fiance. It will directly affect our children. And there is no, I've never seen this much momentum, this much leverage behind the movement. And so for me, going into a bubble, I was taking myself out of having the impact that I want to have. I want to be on the front lines. I want to be in my communities of Philadelphia and DC and countless other communities around the country. And to be impactful means to be present. And so for that, I wanted to sit out and tackle this head on 100%, 2 feet in, not 1 foot in, 1 foot out.
I know we're supposed to be social distancing, but if you were here, I would hug you. Girl, you got it. You got it. You get what's going on. And I have to, amen, I applaud you.
I appreciate it.
The league is dedicating this season to social justice and will be wearing the warm-up shirts with the phrases Black Lives Matter and Say Her Name on them. Black Lives Matter will also be on the courts during games, but you say people shouldn't be distracted by the crumbs. Explain what you mean by that.
Crumbs, to me, right now are t-shirts, our post on Instagram, our fads that fade away.
Say it, please.
Taking down statues of racist slave owners that should have never been put up, taking down names of buildings on college campuses that should have never been named that. That's crumbs. That's what they're giving to our community. That's what they're giving to us in order to, here we go. We gave you what you wanted. This is us. We're giving you what you guys wanted. But no, I don't want crumbs. I want the whole plate. I want my entire meal. I came for my meal. Okay, I'm hungry. So that's why I say don't get distracted by the crumbs. I'm so proud of the women that went into the bubble. I know they're going to do big things, and they're keeping the attention where it needs to be, whether it's having the names on the back of their jerseys or Black Lives Matter on the court. It's phenomenal. But we need real change. Real change is defunding our police departments and allocating that money into our marginalized communities, whether it's schools, hospitals, food, taking care of
our... You don't worry about that slogan, the whole defund the police department, because a lot of people are afraid of that slogan. They think it means getting rid of police altogether.
Absolutely not. And that's... You're going to have... It's a spectrum. You're going to have people... There's always a spectrum for whatever reason in our country. You're going to have people that are like, get rid of police. And you're going to have people that are just saying, defund them. I'm one of those people that believes that, do we need our police departments? Yes, we need them to serve and protect our communities. But I do believe that they need to be defunded, and right, money needs to be taken out of departments and allocated elsewhere, because especially in our marginalized communities, they're suffering.
In
a lot of areas.
I'm out of time, Natasha, but you were great. You should come work for us.
I appreciate it.
No, we can't. We'll be right back. We have to. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. CNN. I appreciate it. Thank you.
I appreciate it.
The most trusted name in news with Natasha Cloud. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.